of the iconic cities I've always wanted to visit is New Orleans. I had never been to Louisiana, though John had worked there for many months installing the Louisiana lottery system years ago, back in the early 90s.
Turns out New Orleans is only 3 hours away from Gulf Shores, so we decided to take a detour and spend a couple days in the city. We went ahead and packed up all of our gear in the van. We said goodbye to the Griffins, and we hit the road.
And before long, we were in the great state of Louisiana. I don't know what it is about New Orleans that's always drawn me. Certainly the history, but also there's a sense of magic that's always emanated from New Orleans, with its voodoo queens and shadow men, and even in modern literature, like Anne Rice's Interview with a Vampire, it's always the spookiness and magic that surrounds New Orleans. As soon as we exited onto Canal Street, we were greeted with the iconic New Orleans streetcars. And though we didn't get to ride them on this trip, it was just so cool to see them buzzing up and down Canal Street.
We were staying in downtown New Orleans, just off the French Quarter. As we pulled into our hotel, the JW Marriott, we see this big bus and realize as we're pulling into the parking area that we are now staying at the same hotel as the Kansas Jayhawks for the Final Four tournament for 2022. Had no idea that the tournament was going on this weekend and that we got booked into that hotel.
The hotel room was amazing, and we thoroughly enjoyed staying there. It even had this amazing view into the French Quarter right out of our window. After a quick refresh, we decided to go and explore the French Quarter.
We had dinner reservations at Arnaud's, a Creole restaurant that had some vegan options.
Located in the heart of the French Quarter, it had all the charm that you would expect. Its beautiful chandeliers, leaded glass windows, and historic portraits. The food was pretty good too. I ordered the soup and the escargot, which was delicious, and John had millet, which was a type of squash.
After dinner, we took a stroll around the French Quarter to get a sense of the nightlife. We did not partake.
We had a perfectly wonderful time, though I could tell something was bothering my guy. He was just a little bit grumpy. Come to find out, he was taking his bodyguard duties very, very seriously, and New Orleans can be challenging.
Christ, I told you why. I can't protect you like this.
how he shows his love. I love you too, babe.
The next morning.
After finishing our beignets and cleaning up all that powdered sugar, we walked over to Jackson Square. We decided to visit the National World War II Museum. We'd visited the World War I Museum in Kansas City and couldn't pass this opportunity up.
The museum has this very cool experience where they tell you the story of World War II through the experience of a specific soldier. You get assigned a card and then you go to different stations throughout the museum to get their perspective on what happened, and you can even follow up on that individual once they returned home. Very cool. Hadn't seen that anywhere before. Once we finished up at the museum, we decided it was time to head for home.